Yes, my name remains Idem Unyimen, member representing Ukanafu Norowonam Federal Constituency in Akwa Ibom State. A call on multi-choice digital satellite television, DStv, and other service providers to introduce the pay-as-you-go tariff plan in Nigeria. The House notes that the National Broadcasting Commission Act empowers the National Broadcasting Commission to regulate the ownership activities or operations of radio and television stations, as well as direct broadcast satellite service providers. And currently, there are over 10 direct-to-home service providers operating in Nigeria and rendering paid services. Also note that DStv, one of the leading direct-to-home service providers in Nigeria, was launched in 1995 and has about 11.9 million subscribers, which is largest market in its operations. Concerned that DStv and other direct-to-home service providers have deliberately refused to implement the pay-as-you-go tariff plan, they rather charge users on a fixed monthly tariff plan, unlike what is obtainable outside Nigeria. Aware that Nigeria constitutes 40% of DStv's global market share, yet over 40% of the citizens do not use a greater part of their paid monthly tariff due to engagement that take them from one location to the other on a daily basis. Hence, they cannot access the services upon expiration, whether or not they use their previous subscription until they renew it for another month. Also aware that DStv operates a pay-as-you-go tariff plan in other countries, but has chosen to exploit Nigerians through a fixed monthly tariff plan. Cognizance that the continuous exploitation of multi-choice owners of DStv constitutes economic sabotage against Nigerians, and most of them pay for services they do not consume, while the company, judging from their average monthly tariff of 8,000 naira per month, if multiplied by 11 million subscribers, makes about 100 billion naira revenue at the expense of its subscribers. The House resolved to urge the federal government to direct multi-choice and other direct-to-home broadcast service providers to implement a pay-as-you-go tariff plan, mandate the committees on information technology and telecommunications to investigate the non-implementation of the pay-as-you-go tariff plan by broadcast satellite service providers with a view to ensuring strict compliance with the tariff plan, and report back to the House within 4 weeks of legislative action. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, I so move.
The people of Abasa Federal Constituency, I rise to second this motion, deeply moved by my colleague. I so second.
Honorable, please lead the debate.
Our distinguished colleagues, once again, my name remains Idem Unyimen, member representing Ukanafu Norowonam Federal Constituency in Akwa Ibom State. Mr. Speaker, I want to say that this issue has to do with the public, has to do with the public interest. And as the people representatives, if we don't do something about this to fight for the rights of the people that we represent, I think our representation will not be complete. The DStv and other satellite service providers has been surcharging Nigerians for several years now. And there have been several calls from these subscribers that their rights has to be protected. They need to give them the right to choose what they want. And that is what is obtainable when it comes to business indulgence. But I don't know why DStv and other satellite service providers choose to ignore the calls by Nigerians. Mr. Speaker, The one that really worries us the most is the fact that when you go to Kenya, where DStv is providing the same service to Kenya, in that place, they are charging pay as you go. And when you consider the population of Kenya, it's just about 47 million compared to the market in Nigeria, 200 million Nigerians. I don't know the market that should enjoy more discounts compared to the two markets. So this situation is something that we need to rise to this challenge as the people representative to fight for their right, for their rights. I know that for us as members of the parliament and other arms of government, people in a well-paid job, we can afford to subscribe maybe 18,000, 12,000 per month. But we are talking about the downtrodden, people that earn 30,000 per month. And at the end of the day, they use about 12,000 to pay for DStv that they don't have control over. These are the people that sometimes in their community, they don't even have light to consume the service. Somebody can subscribe, you know, to this service today and then stay for the whole maybe 2-3 weeks without using this service. And by next month, another 12,000 will go for the same service. I think they are taking the ignorance, they are taking advantage of the ignorance of these subscribers to surcharge them. So that's why, as a country, we need to rise to put a stop to this. And if they say it is not possible for this to be implemented in Nigeria, I think by the time they come, they will explain to us why it is possible in Kenya and other countries, and it's not possible in Nigeria. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, I want you to rise this morning to fight for the people that we are representing, our constituents, by compelling them to implement pay-as-you-go tariff. That is the global best practice. Anywhere you go to, that's what they do. I can take you back to the issue of telecommunication. When they launched the operation 2001 in Nigeria, the same method, the same pattern, the same tariff plan was what they used. And when we confronted them at that time, they said it's not possible. But I was so shocked. When they let entrants enter the market, the game changed automatically. I think we need to rise and ensure that the same benefit that Nigerians are getting in the telecommunication industry is what they want when it comes to satellite television providers. Mr. Speaker, I so submit. Thank you very much.
I remain Honorable Gordon Ndebele, and I represent the good people of Anyoto in the federal concern from Delta State. I want to amend prayer one to read that we set up an ad hoc committee to look into this and report back to the House within 4 weeks.
Okay, so your prayer, any seconder? Honorable Nolly.
Oh. Representing just South, just East Federal Constituency from Plateau, arise to second the amendment by the Minority Leader, Honorable Elumin.
Those in support and subsidy for an ad hoc committee, please say aye. Those against, please say nay. Ayes have it. Honorable Nolly, you have an amendment?
Speaker, distinguished colleagues, my name is Nolly Naji. I represent in Kano East and West Federal Constituency and from Enugu State. Mr. Speaker, my amendment goes, since we are referring it to ad hoc committee, we also mandate the ad hoc committee to liaise with the NBC, because it's not ministry communication, it's National Broadcasting Corporation. It's not the Ministry of Communication. NBC, yes, and information.
Yeah, so your amendment is that the ad hoc committee should liaise with NBC. That's part of their work. They must. Oh, no. That was deleted. That was the amendment Honorable Elumelu moved to delete all of that. And yes. So communication and all of that, they're out of it. Okay. Well, Prestige.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Honorable colleagues, Mr. Speaker, my
amendment that we've taken by events, the minority leader's amendment has covered mine. So I'm stepping it down, Mr. Speaker.
All right, so we'll just put the question to the substantive motion. Those in favor of the motion as amended, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say nay. Ayes have it.